in the world of fragrance, making you smell delicious and offending you at the same time may be considered especially heinous. In New York City, a gorgeous Cubano and his elite squad of ball sprayers will seek out these colognes and investigate them. This is his story, bitch.
You already know what time of year it is. That's right. Every motherfucker in the world is dropping their top 10 list. And I was like, fuck that. I'm not doing that shit. I'm lying. Of course I'm doing it. Because I'm a little bitch. You already know Kuba's going to be dropping that top 10 designer. Does anybody even dab anymore? That's how old and dusty my ass is. Doing shit that kids were doing like 3 years ago. Let's roll my motherfucking music because these videos give me the shits. And if I happen to poop on myself right on camera, I might just get more views. Listen, morning, my beautiful peoples. You know who it is. It's your boy, C to the U to the B to the A, aka Thotty Banger. You already know I got the 10 ready. 10 designer fragrances that I'm gonna be fucking with this year and that I think y'all motherfuckers should be fucking with as well. Now, they are not gonna be in any specific order because that takes time and energy, and I'm not a real reviewer, so therefore I don't do any of these things. So let's get right into this designer list, shall we? My one and only honorable mention will be Tommy Endless Blue. I don't know if I've even reviewed this shit on my channel. I got this shit for the dirt for like literally like $10 at Marshall's. And honestly, it's really not bad. It's definitely for that young buck ready to fuck kind of vibe. It only lasts for maybe 68 seconds on your skin. So you definitely want to throw this like in a gym bag or one of these really just chill young buck fragrances. You know, once they start sweating and smelling funny, that kind of age bracket, you can respray this shit 150 times and it's not going to really last that great. At least on my skin, it really doesn't do that phenomenal, but it's actually a decent scent, especially for the price that I bagged it for, $10. I mean, it might be a little bit more expensive elsewhere, but that's not what I paid for it, so fuck it. That's why it's an honorable mention, and Tommy Hilfiger was on my shit list for a long time. I've let him back into my world because I'm trying to be an old head and resurrect my youth. Maybe I'll start wearing denim overalls with a big flag on my chest and Timberland boots unlaced. I do that already, next one. Believe it or not, I really haven't had a chance to enjoy this fragrance because everybody in my circle used to wear this shit, and that's Burberry Touch. Now, Burberry Touch, I never really wore because as I mentioned in a previous video that all my motherfuckers was wearing this shit. Why am I gonna smell like the next five dudes that are rocking with me? All my wingmen smelling the same? That shit is weird. Smells like a bunch of dudes who are just cuddling on a California king size bed. I'm not judging, but I'm judging a little bit. And I'm rarely around them as much as I used to. I cannot wear this shit and not be worried about motherfuckers around me smelling like this. Damn, this is actually a really good scent, and it's gonna be interesting to smell this shit on myself now as a grown adult. Maybe it'll bring me back to those good old times where I used to bag up numbers and they used to be fake numbers, and then I used to cry and just leave massive stains on my pit. Next one. For y'all bitter and salty motherfuckers, this one is always on your summer list, and I'm sure a ton of people are gonna agree with me that it would be Bulgari Aqua Amara, aka Salty Motherfucker. You spray this shit on your skin more than five times, your skin will wilt like a little bit of a prune because it is salty as shit, super aquatic, very salty, beached vibes for sure. Great in extreme heat. I'm talking about those Arizona desert heats that I hear is obnoxiously high and dry. I can't be in that shit. Look at my fucking skin. I'm gonna come out looking like a Red Lobster 2-for-1 meal. But everybody loves this shit in the summer, and so do I. So when the high heat hits, or that crazy New York humidity hits, and I hit fucking Point Pleasant or Seaside Heights, I'm gonna be fucking with this shit. Next one. This one I haven't reviewed on my channel, but a review will be coming soon, and that's Old Navy's joint, which is Kindred Good Sea Salt and Fig. This shit was like nothing dollars because this was sent to me over by Josh over at Scent Sense. Thank you so much, my brother. He knows I fuck with Fig. Who doesn't know I love Fig? This is actually a very good fragrance. The performance is so-so, but most freshies are kind of crappy on the performance aspect. But this is actually a very decent fragrance. Super portable, was dirt cheap until it got hyped crazy, and then motherfuckers was trying to get like $40, $50 out of this shit. You stupid as fuck if you paid that kind of paper for this shit. It's very good, and it's should be more expensive. However, it wasn't, so stop trying to upcharge a bitch. Salty, figgy, fresh, aquatic, sea breeze note kind of thing inside. I think it's fucking great. That Tommy shit is a lot worse than this one, and it was around the same price point. Next one. This motherfucker right here is never talked about. I'm pretty much the only one who's ever spoken about this fragrance, and it should get a little bit more love, and I think it's usually in my summer list because of that creamy sickle vibe, and that's Vince Camuto's Solara. Now, Solara is just delicious. It's kind of, I think, a slightly better interpretation of Mugler's zesty orange, orange zest. You know what the fuck I'm talking about. The other creamsicle shit. This one's a little bit more refined, a little bit more designer-esque. This one's got that mass appealing quality. It's definitely got that nighttime airy vibe with a little bit of creamy orange. Musky, light florals, creamy, citrus, bright. Fun. I think this is super fun, very casual, very chill. You can wear it, transition from afternoon to evening time, reapply it, of course. And it was also super fucking cheap. This is a tester bottle, tattooed tester in the back. And I got this shit, I think it was like under 25 bucks. So this shit was pretty awesome. And Vince Camuto Solara, if you haven't smelled this shit, try to find this shit for the super low, cause it'll surprise you. Next one. Another Young Buck fragrance that actually performs really well and has one of the best melon notes that I've smelled in a designer fragrance. And that's Abercrombie & Bitch First Instinct. First Instinct is actually very solid. I know it's a little younger than my old ass should be wearing, but I don't give a flying fuck because I'm gonna wear what I wanna wear when I wanna wear it. If I wanna feel youthful, if I wanna just ferment the fucking white hairs on my beard, I will do so in spray First Instinct. Good fucking performance for this fragrance. That's why a lot of motherfuckers in this fragrance community be jocking this shit, because it's dope. I would just buy this shit online. I was never comfortable going to the Abercrombie & Fitch store and seeing a prepubescent teen that doesn't even have pubes on his body with no shirt on and a fucking banana hammock standing in front of the door handing out a 2-for-1 flyer. Nah, son, we not rocking that shit. I'll smack the shit out of you and pinch your nipple at the same time. This is actually super good, very bright, more youthful, but old heads like myself can be rocking this type of shit, and y'all motherfuckers should get your hands on it if you haven't, which most of you have, so next one. I ain't even gonna talk about this shit too much. Y'all know this is my bitch from Banana Republic, Linen Vetiver. I recommended this shit to a bunch of motherfuckers and they all share the same opinion. Kuba, you's right. That shit is amazing. Super fresh, fresh laundry, delicious linen, super bright vetiver, sparkly, effervescent, just energetic, lively. I think this is beautiful. One of the best Banana Republic fragrances I've gotten my nose on. The quality is great. The performance is really good. The price point was fucking exceptional. And the fragrance itself is outstanding. I love this fragrance. I'm gonna be using the flying fuck out of this shit because this is a regular chill fragrance and I'm a chill type of dude. So Banana Republic Linen Vetiver, you my bitch boo for this summer. Hold up. Next one. This is another motherfucker that's been listed in one of my summer fragrance videos before because it's fucking great and people don't give this shit the love that it deserves. Well, I love it. And that's Hermes Voyage. I always think this is good. It's spicy. It's warm. It's intoxicating. It's got a nice cardamom blast. It's got a fresh aquatic feel. It's got some light florals. It's got that spicy factor that most freshies don't really have, with a decent performance to say the least. I feel like I'm supposed to wear all white linen when I rock this shit. And maybe one of those little, you know, it's like Spanish people slippers, them leather shits that your toes be hanging on, your toe hairs be chilling. They look kind of like Jesus sandals, but they're not yet Birkenstocks. They're a little fancier. That's the type of shit that I feel like when I wear like Hermes Voyage. You know what I'm saying? Rent a yacht, be stunting, use the credit card, then call in credit card fraud and be like, yo, I didn't charge that shit. I don't even like boats. I'm seasick. Next one. Taking it back to the old school because I'm an old fool. Who's so cool? Bringing it back to 1994 with Quasar. I mentioned Quasar in my throwback video. Quasar is back in my collection and I will be using this fruity banana leaf balm. This motherfucker is filled with sage, greenery, super fruity cocktail opening, very bright. The performance is dope on my skin, and I'm gonna be limited edition like the McRib rocking this shit in the street because nobody, I repeat, nobody around me is gonna be wearing this shit. Fact. Not only that, this shit used to be like a $40, $50 fragrance, and right now, motherfuckers is trying to hit you over the head for almost $200. You stoops, fam. We not doing that. Had to get this shit overseas, but you know what? Brings me back to my childhood, and this shit is, ooh, man. Fruity cocktail, citrusy opening, that banana leaf. Yeah, buddy. Yo, I'm gonna be smelling like an old motherfucker, cause I am. Next one. Yo, Guerlain has the best almond notes in the game. This is just so different from every other freshie on this list and every other freshie around, because it's fucking Guerlain. Guerlain be doing it on the low. Oh my God, it's just earthy, nutty, crisp, and kind of velvety. As I like to use the term, aromatherapeutic. This is just sexy, seductive, close encounter. It's just good. I usually don't like nut all over my neck, but in this particular case, I'll take it. Guerlain Ideal Cologne is just fire. Check this bitch out, next one. Last and certainly not least, one of the very few Chanels that I own, and that's Chanel Allure Edition Blanche. That lemony lime 7-Up kind of opening is so dope, with a nice pink pepper and that beautiful white floral with a thick sandalwood and a musky vibe. It's just dope. It hits all the fucking senses that you want in the high heat. This performs very well. It's one of my favorite allures. I know a lot of people like the OXtreme and all that other shit. This is the one that I fuck with. This is the one that I consistently grab in the summertime. As a matter of fact, it's actually running a little bit low, so I'm gonna chillax and wear the other ones, because I don't want this shit to go to waste, because I just don't want to buy it again. It's not the easiest to catch for a decent price, because, you know, Chanel don't be discounting shit. They'll sue a motherfucker before they discount it. Let's speak facts. Chanel don't come after me. I'm broke. Chanel Allure Edition Blanche, you got it. I don't even know why I'm talking about it. That's my summer designer list. If this video gets over 100 thumbs up, maybe I'll drop a niche one, if y'all motherfuckers really want it, because I know y'all probably super exhausted of the 58 videos that have been dropped of designer top 10, top 20, top 50, top 100. I dropped the top 100 and that video didn't get no love. This is bullshit. I just don't know the temperature of YouTube lately. Motherfuckers go left, motherfuckers go right. Half y'all bitches is bipolar, but you know what? I still fuck with y'all because I love y'all, and I'm standing here essentially talking to myself. All these joints is ball sprayers. We not doing that, because you know wifey gets pissed when I start spraying all this shit on the carpet. I'm not trying to get smacked, especially on camera. I love y'all motherfuckers from the heart, and these unsprayed balls that are ready for summertime. They are freshly shaved and ready to get dipped in the ocean. I'll see y'all bitches next time. You know who it is. It's the biggest in the motherfucking game. Smooches.
For the fly gun holder, money folder, Motorola star tag when it's time to call back. For the rough, rugged, and raw way, this nigga Jay, it's a game, but he don't play. Ay. For all the chicks that got dead in the penthouse suite on top of my mom's crib. It's nonsense you never get in. It's nonsense that you would think that.